Oh, Hannah, what I'm guessing the past few weeks, it's all anyone's wanting to talk about.
Yeah,
it's been really, all consuming, I guess.
It's really all systems go at the moment, but we're so excited to share the final season with everyone. It's
yeah,
a really exciting
because
time.
It was obviously shot quite a while ago, so now all of a sudden you're reliving this whole big period of your life.
It's very weird, yeah.
How do you deal with trying to keep this a secret? Is it a difficult thing? Because you must get constantly asked, what's happening?
Yeah,
and of course you can't say.
I can't say, but I'm really bad at it. I always want to tell everyone, and I once ruined a big spoiler for my friend at his birthday party. I decided to tell him everything. so I always worry I'm gonna get in trouble, but I'm really relieved the show's coming out so I can finally talk about it with
everyone. Yes, it's just, yes, absolutely. You can breathe after every episode now. It obviously has taken over a massive chunk of your life now, Hannah, most of your 20s, in fact.
Yeah.
How does that feel now that it's coming to an end?
It feels like the end of school or the end of university or the end of any kind of really significant time with such an important group of people.
I suppose as well the show has provided you with these incredible opportunities. I mean, you've been all over the world with it as well.
Yes.
And it's opened so many doors. It is something that you can look back on and think, I was part of something that really was on another level.
Yeah, I think it's going to take a while to really sink in what a phenomenon the show is. I watched the first episode of the final season at our premiere in New York with a small group of 5,000 people, which was very fun because it's such a great, it's such a sort of crowd-pleasing episode, that first one, I think. And it's amazing to see like the audience reaction and people cheering and clapping every time their favorite characters come on screen. But I think I'll watch it I live in LA now, and I think I'll watch the rest of the season with just a group of friends. Because it's so fun. It's such a fun show to watch with people, I think.
Of course. If they're fans, everyone has an opinion.
Yeah,
they all have bought into it. I mean, when you think back to the days in Skins, Hannah, all those years ago, you were only 16, weren't
17.
You? 17. 17 in Skins. Like, you were a baby, practically.
Yeah.
And do you look back on those days fondly? I mean, or is it just like some crazy distant memory?
Oh, no. That was some of the happiest time in my life. I mean, I fell in love with acting so hard and fast as soon as I started working on Skins. And then those people that I worked with on that show, they're my best friends. I mean, they're almost like my siblings, really. We're that close. And I see them all the time. They're just such an important part of my life. So I feel like that sort of thread from that first job is still very, very consistent.
Yeah, it's sort of the foundation in many ways,
yeah,
I suppose.
Yeah.
And I love the fact you did take a little bit of time away from acting to go, and you studied, actually.
Yeah,
you wanted
I did
to
an
study
English
literature.
Degree. Yeah.
Which is really interesting. And do you think that was something that you felt you really had to do just to kind of give you a bit more direction into what you wanted to do?
I just wanted to do it. I really, really loved literature and I loved reading and I think I wanted to take a bit of time out from the industry and just have a bit more of a wider perspective on life. And I love that I have friends who are doctors and lawyers and do all kinds of different things. And I think it really helps. I think an English degree really, really helps with acting as well because you study the text so closely and it helps with scripts. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Now moving away, of course, from Game of Thrones because no matter what any of us want, it is coming to an end. So you are involved in this new movie called Charlie Says.
Yes.
So tell us about this. This is really interesting to me, actually.
Yeah, so it's a movie about the women who killed for Charles Manson.
Yeah.
And went to prison for them, and it looks at their time in prison and their time in the cult with sort of flashbacks to their time with Charlie.
Yeah.
And it's just examining them as individuals and trying to understand
what made
why
them
they
do
did
it.
What they
yes,
did.
And
yeah.
just the control he had over them.
Yeah,
it's an extraordinary story when you see the facts involved.
Yeah.
And quite a powerful role, I'm guessing. It's to play a real person.
Yes.
Again, that must be quite a difficult thing.
It is a difficult thing. It's like it's a lot of responsibility and it's very complicated and it's particularly when it's someone who's been through such dark experiences but I think that despite what she did it is possible to have empathy for her because she was so young and she was under this influence of this very very manipulative man and I just think that watching the journey that she goes on during this film is there's this amazing kind of you see her getting brainwashed and then you see her in prison working with Carlene Faith, who was a graduate student who came in to work with the women. You see her getting kind of unbrainwashed and finding herself again and realizing that what she did was wrong.
What she's done. It's a really interesting one and a great part for you, obviously, Hannah, because it's such an intense one.